A voice of calm.
Once it gets below five and it remains below five, it doesn't have to be zero, we are in a very safe place.
Professor Mary-Louise McLaws helped us navigate one of the most stressful times of our lives, a constant and reassuring presence on our show.
And Mary-Louise, what do you make of the Premier's path out?
As well as many others.
Good to have you on the program with us again.
While the COVID pandemic thrust her into the limelight, Mary-Louise was already a world leader in the fight against infectious diseases. She served as an advisor to the WHO in China, worked in Hong Kong to control the outbreak of SARS, aided infection control research in countries including Cambodia, Iran, and Vietnam. She also made significant contributions to the elimination of HIV, hepatitis B and C, and was pivotal to containing the spread of swine flu. When COVID appeared, it seemed her whole life had been in preparation for that moment.
She was able to really provide that broader perspective that we all benefited from so much.
Among the first to talk about the need for masks,
it greatly suppresses that spread.
An early advocate for isolating and vaccination.
Vaccines are very safe.
Mary-Louise died peacefully in her sleep on Saturday, just 18 months after she announced her brain tumour diagnosis. And she encouraged the nation to support brain tumour research.
My brother died a couple of years ago from brain cancer, so it's very important to our family of what you're doing, so thank you.
Thanks, Mary-Louise. We had no idea.
To now have lost Mary-Louise to the same disease is so incredibly tragic. And, yeah, my heart very much goes out to their family today.
Last year, Mary-Louise was honoured with an Order of Australia for her service to medical research. And today, from scientists to politicians to those who watched her on our TV screens across Australia, tributes have flowed.
She was extraordinary and, yeah, she almost became like part of the family.
A gentle and authoritative voice through one of modern Australia's most challenging times.
We're only here for a short time, and it's not what we do, it's what we leave behind.
Thank you, Mary-Louise.
Professor Robyn Richmond was a colleague and friend to Mary-Louise. Robyn, during the pandemic, epidemiologists became television personalities, celebrities, if you will. What did she make of that and all the fuss?
We're very mindful of her becoming the star that she was during COVID, but she was very experienced in communicating, which she did in different settings, not just in the media, but in organisations like the WHO. She was a wonderful teacher. She was terrific at supervising students. Often I'd walk along the corridor to my office and see her there sitting at her desk, and we all have that wonderful image of her sitting at desk, her desk at her house with the blue wall and her dark glasses. Mm. She was there with her students with two screens, not one but two monitors, where they were looking at the figures that the PhD student had. They thought very highly of her as well. So she's a person who is very skilled at speaking to different sorts of people.
Brain cancer is such a horrible, horrible disease, and it kills so quickly. We only first heard about this in her case 18 months ago, and here we are today. What was she like through that fight, like through that 18-month period?
Well, I thought she was extremely strong. She knew what she was going in for because her brother had died from the same disease, glioblastoma, only a few years before. And she was very calm. She described what was going to happen. And I think it was tremendously courageous of her, I must say.
She was calm in the face of brain cancer. She was calm in the face of COVID. Did you ever see her flustered?
Oh, probably, yes. COVID about, problems with people, certain people that she might be having difficulties with. But when it came to the big issues, the serious things that were going on, like the pandemic, like when she got cancer, she was a very calm and consistent woman, I must say. She is a tremendous role model of courage for standing up for what she believes in. And she used that across many different arenas. There were a lot of people who challenged her. She got quite fussed about that. because she had the evidence and she didn't believe that others should be providing certain things, certain attitudes, and yet they were probably out of date. Basically, that's what I would say. And she tried to give the facts and the evidence, which she did.
Robyn, we really do appreciate your time on such a sad day. Thank you so much for your time this evening.
It's a pleasure.
Such incredibly sad news. I was so upset when I heard the news today because she was such a calm voice in such a tumultuous time. Mm-hmm. And I remember there was a point in the pandemic where we were getting sort of conflicting advice on what to do, and this person thought this and this person thought that. And I remember thinking to myself, what would Mary-Louise do?
Yeah.
Just do whatever she says. You know, she was sort of really, really trusted. And it got to a point where we started joking about her white bookshelf, you know, having more screen time than any of us during the pandemic. And, you know, she was in on the joke too. So
the word that comes to my mind, or came to my mind this morning, was dignified. That just summarised how she carried herself. And even the way she would limit her views on things. Like, I remember we were talking about coming out of lockdowns and that sort of thing. And she said, look, I'm an epidemiologist. I would like to just keep going until... But I'm not an economist and I'm not... Mm. You know, and I understand people who consider those things might have different views. So she obviously knew more about it than almost anyone else on the planet. But she was able to recognise, this is my field, this is not my field. I can give you my advice on this. I'm not giving my advice on that. And that's rare, I think.
Yeah, tremendous loss. Yeah.
Incredible woman.
She was. Well, in honour of Mary-Louise, the Brain Cancer Centre has opened a fundraiser. If you would like to donate, you can head to the link below.